The point is just to throw something out there and see what works and see what type of an audience you're going to want to work with. Hey guys, and welcome to this week's episode of Social Marketing. My name is Eric Hammond of the Orange Stack, and I appreciate you guys following along each week as we help you uncover how to use social media in your strategies as a business owner. There's so much you can do with social media, and each week we try to uncover, you know, how to generate business, how to tell your story, how to build your brand, and most importantly, how to close deals from using social media. So in today's episode, we are going to get very nitty gritty and specific on something, but this is something that's been changing a lot, and I want to help you guys understand how to do this better in your business. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about how to really audit an audience, a targeted audience on your Facebook ads, right? So when you basically create the ad, you have the opportunity to decide who's going to see this content. You know, right now there's roughly 230 million people in the United States on Facebook at any given time. And what Facebook allows you to do is, you know, what's the purpose of your ad? Who are you trying to get this in front of? Are you trying to target specific interests such as homeowners or renters or people that work at certain businesses? Things like that, right? And if you have no idea what I'm talking about, you need to go back to like 101 Facebook and watch some of that content, because we tell you how to build out a whole Facebook. There's a couple videos that we have. Maybe we can put a link up here somewhere. But there's videos on how to basically create your whole structure of an ad and how to target the people that you want to reach out to. So what we're going to do is, when you're creating your Facebook ad and you're trying to either sell a piece of property or you're trying to capture a lead to find somebody who's interested in selling their property, you got to think about that homeowner or that buyer, that persona, right? That avatar, if you will. What do they look like? What are they interested in? And, you know, how are you going to speak to them as a real estate agent? So there's a couple of different ways that you can go about this. One is to say, let's target the geographic area that this house is in and say, you know, who wants to live in this community? It's probably going to be like a 5-mile radius, depending on what ad campaign you choose. But, you know, who's going to want to be moving into this area if you're trying to sell a home? Let's say you have an open house and you're trying to get visitors to that open house, or you're just trying to get people who might be interested in learning more information about that house. You're going to target people who are wanting to move in there. We work with a lot of clients who have move-in traffic from other states, so they may not be in that 5-mile radius. They may be moving from Columbus, Ohio to your town because they like the weather better there, or there's a vacation spot that they like there, right? So it doesn't always work to be geographic in that sense. The other option is to target people based on their habits, okay? So, you know, if you're working with an area that has a big business that they work in, like talk about Boeing or Toyota or Pepsi or Coke or some big brand that exists in your community, and maybe they're hiring a lot of people. I know in the Bay Area, there's a lot of big tech companies that hire in big, huge droves. So, you know, so they get big move-in traffic from these companies, and they're coming from all over the world for these jobs. We have in Southern California, you know, there's a lot of government jobs. There's a lot of medical sales positions. So if you knew a company that was hiring in your area and they just hired 400 people, there's going to be a big move-in of people from that company. So what you can do is go into the interest-based part of your Facebook ad, and maybe we'll put a couple screenshots up here just to show you what I'm talking about. But when, as you can see here, you're going to be able to target people based off the interest. So maybe it's interest in Toyota as an employer, right? Or maybe it's, you know, I'm interested in working with the software company. Maybe it's Microsoft, right? Take Microsoft, for example. If Microsoft's hiring a whole bunch of people in that area, you want to target people who are interested in Microsoft as an employee, or they are an employee of Microsoft. Get the idea here? So what you're going to do is basically create your ad, pick Microsoft, pick the employee, not the interest in it, because you don't want people who are interested in Microsoft products. That's not going to help you. There's going to be millions of people who are interested in that. But if they're interested in being an employee of that company, that's who you're wanting to target. And what you want to do, and what I'm getting at here, is that you want to test out these audiences, okay? So maybe you feel like Microsoft is hiring and that's a good demographic to target to, but maybe they're hiring locally and they don't need anybody who's going to be moving from out of state. So what you want to do is actually create separate ad sets for each of these interests that you're coming up with, okay? So maybe you target people who work at a certain company. Talked about all those already. Maybe you talk about or target people with a certain income level. So meet with your lender, find out, okay, I'm selling this, whatever, $400,000 home. What does somebody need to make to qualify for this $400,000 home? Target that income level, you know? So maybe it's, I'm just throwing out numbers here. Maybe it's $100,000 to $150,000 of income. And I'm way off, I know, I'm just using numbers. You can target people of an income of $100,000 to $150,000. $50,000 people or dollars of income for the year. Okay, so that's another interest group. What happens is you're going to want to create like four or five of these interest groups and create a new ad set for each of them. Okay, so I'm going kind of quick through this, but what happens is after you create ad sets, and maybe you have four ad sets and you have like Toyota or Microsoft being one of them, you have an income level as being another one of them, and come up with another two, right? I'm just spitballing these ideas. Once you have your four ad set ideas, create a short video. Okay, this doesn't need to be fancy. This is just super short and quick, maybe 30 seconds, something like this in front of a green screen or outside, wherever you are. And basically just have something simple like this, you know? Hey, my name's Eric. Have you thought about buying a home in this community? I would love to talk to you more and see what it is that you're looking to purchase. Click on the button below and start the Messenger app and let's communicate and see what it is that you're looking to purchase in this area, okay? So you're gonna make it easy. You're gonna keep them on Facebook so they can respond in the Messenger app. You can start that two-way conversation. You don't need to capture names and email and all that kind of information. What the goal here is you're trying to get video views, okay? So you're gonna actually optimize these ads for the 30-second video that becomes. And you're gonna try to get as many video views as possible. And then what you're gonna do is out of those four, see which of those ad sets had the best performance. And maybe the first two had an average of a 50% video watch time and the other two had less than 10. Those other two are duds, okay? Drop those. You wanna focus on the two best performing ones, and now you're gonna recreate a better piece of content to go in front of these two. The point is just to throw something out there and see what works and see what type of an audience you're gonna wanna work with. And the reason I bring all this up is because Facebook's changing their interest-based targeting all the time. Things that you were able to once target a few months ago are gone. There's new stuff that you haven't even thought about that's targetable now. So I would keep running these type of tests and just keep putting new audiences into your group and seeing what works and what doesn't. The days of just targeting somebody who's likely to move or interested in Zillow or owns a home, those days are gone from getting easy, cheap, qualified leads. You have to think around the box and think about different ways to target these people. Think about if I'm a new person coming to this area because of this job for Toyota, what am I going to do to look for a home? You know, what are the things that are interesting to them? So think about it from your client's perspective, okay? So basically, you're running a bunch of ads, you're trying to find out what your audience needs to be like, and then you're gonna go deep. So let's just say Toyota was that one ad set that worked, okay? Now go create a great piece of content. I'm not gonna get into that right now, but go create a great piece of content that can fit into that ad. Maybe it's a minute long video, maybe it's a blog to read, maybe it's a video of a house, whatever it is. You have a perfect audience now that you can target, and now you're gonna go retarget that audience and you're gonna increase your budget, and then you're also gonna create a lookalike audience of anybody who kind of matched that category. So Facebook knows what you're trying to do. They can make it easier for you to get in front of new people. So that's really how you test out a specific targeted audience and go deeper on it, and then also find different ways to approach finding that person who's probably needing to buy or sell a house that you can reach out to. Man, this is a deep video, and if you have questions, reach out to me. I'd love to talk to you more about it. But guys, thanks for following along. We uncover and develop social media strategies to help you in your business. Again, this is probably like level 4.0 or higher, but you know, go check out some of our maybe mid-level videos to help you guys get some strategies on how to use social media in your business. Thanks for following along each week. We'll see you on the next one.